The plantation industry is a very important industry in the Malaysia's transformation program. In fact, rubber and oil palm are the two crops that have entered into the 12 key economic areas that the government is promoting. And certainly, if we can see from the record of the years, I think the palm oil industry, for instance, had a long history of being able to support the country when it was necessary. I think I have to go back to the financial turbulence of 1998, for instance. I think palm oil industry has stood with Malaysia and has helped solve some of the worst effect of the 1998 crisis. Last year, the palm oil industry contributed to about 20% of Malaysia's export earnings, right up to over 83 billion ringgit, an increase of more than 20% from the previous year. So I think this will continue to grow, and I think all the other industries will continue to grow. And in view of this, Malaysia is looking at the commodity sector as an area of growth, not just from the upstream, but also from the downstream sector. For example, in the oil palm industry, we are going further downstream into the pharmaceutical, nutraceutical, and all this, and not just becoming a producer of raw materials. In the case of rubber as well, it's the same. We are not just concentrating on the upstream, but further going downstream so that there's a lot of value addition to what you are producing. In fact, in as far as rubber is concerned, Malaysia is also already importing latex from surrounding countries. And we're hoping that all this value adding will be put to good use. Contribution by the commodities sector to the GDP, GNI of Malaysia has been very progressive. And I think if we look over the period of last year, we have contributed about 114 million billion ringgit, and we are hoping that over the period from now to 2020, it will reach to about 240 billion ringgit. We are looking at a contribution of about 7% to the GDP of the country for the commodities. If you look at Malaysia's commodities sector, roughly, the country has an area of about 32 million hectares. Now, half of it, as I think you know, under the Rio summit, Malaysia has already said it will be under forest cover, which means that there will be nothing else grown except trees. The other half is divided into agricultural activities and the land that is required for buildings and stadiums and roads and the shopping centers and all the residential areas. So roughly, you're talking about now only a quarter of the land available in Malaysia that can be used for agriculture. Out of these, 5 million hectares has been utilized for the planting of the oil palm, another 1 million for rubber, perhaps 20,000 for cocoa, and a little bit less for the other crops like paper and tobacco. All this means that the predominant crop here is the oil palm industry, and I think we now produce 90 million tons a year of crude palm oil. The biggest export market is China, of course, for the oil palm industry. And I think all our commodities are really looking at the growth that we see in China coming over the years. Today, the oil palm industry exports about 20% of our products go to China, followed by India, the United States, the European Union, and Pakistan. They are well above 1 million each. This, in fact, for the United States, it's more than 1 million. But overall, I think the biggest market is China, and I think we are looking at the growth in China to be very stable over the years. And it is for this reason that we think that the long-term prospects of our commodities are very good. I think investments can go in the downstream. What we are trying to do now here is because we now have reached a point where there's not much more land available for the planting of crops like oil palm and rubber and cocoa. And therefore, the first thing for us to do is to increase productivity in the upstream sector. That means for every hectare of land utilized for the oil palm industry or rubber, there must be an increase in productivity. Downstream, we are looking at the development of new innovations, technologies, and all this that can value add to the crops. In the case of the oil palm industry, we are going into the pharmaceutical industry, nutraceutical, and of course the oleochemicals. And I think the prospects are very good because the world is growing. The world population is getting larger, even for the supply of oil, as in oils and fats. I think we have a very important role in seeing that the 9 billion population in the year 2050 will get some help from Malaysia in trying to solve how to feed this growing world population. I think we're helping our smallholders very much. At the moment, the government is going on a replanting and a new planting program, in which we are helping the smallholders to replant or to plant new areas. You know, the oil palm industry, for example, in Malaysia, 40% of the industry, at least in the upstream level, that is the planting of oil palm and all this, are in the hands of smallholders. In the rubber sector, most of the holdings are smallholders, and government is helping the smallholders in replanting them and in trying to identify new technologies so that the downstream sector can take the crops that they produce and be able to give them better returns for their labor. I think we subscribe to this world view that what we must do must be sustainable. That means there must be a balance between people, planet, and profit. And I suppose it must be in that order so that no sector will suffer at the expense of another. And I think we want to ensure that the products that we produce in this country are sustainable. We are well aware of all these accusations about our products from all these NGOs. And of course, as you know, the NGOs of the world have a different worldview of the environment. Here we are looking at the hard facts of how to help our people get out of poverty and how to ensure that they have a living, and therefore that what we do is sustainable. We're very, very, very concerned on the environment because, you know, I think that Malaysia's tourism industry is a very important industry for us. We are host to more than 20 million people every year, and I think people who come to Malaysia partly want to see an environment that is conducive to their holidays, and I think we realize that it is very important for us to preserve the environment. And for us Malaysians too, we want an environment for us to live and for our children to grow. Now I think this is not lost on the policymakers, and we are just like anybody else trying to ensure that there's a balance in all the things that we do.